Hello and welcome to a very special episode of VoiceVox. Today we are going to be looking at Christmas and New Year. So, appropriately enough, we are here in Sukhbatar Square in front of the city's Christmas tree. Now, in the West, the Christmas tree is a symbol of Christmas and families like to take trees into their homes and decorate them with baubles, tinsel, fairy lights and make them look beautiful. But Julian, can you tell us why people in the West celebrate Christmas?
Well, traditionally we celebrate Christmas to mark the birth of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is of course the symbol of the Christian faith. But today most families celebrate Christmas as a time of giving. It's when families come together and exchange presents, Christmas cards, sit down for lovely meals and celebrate the year that's gone. How do you celebrate Christmas in Scotland, Andrew?
Well, in Scotland, it is quite cold, so we like to stay inside. And we have a huge meal with turkey, roast potatoes, vegetables, and we like to drink champagne, maybe have some Scottish whisky. And then later, we like to open some presents. I like to get presents, but sometimes I like to give them too. But in Australia, I hear at this time of year, it is actually summer. So how do you celebrate Christmas?
That's right, it is summer in Australia for Christmas because we're in the southern hemisphere. So unlike most of the world, we get to celebrate Christmas a little bit differently. We get to spend time outdoors, we go to the beach, we have Christmas barbecues, go for drinks in the park, a little bit of cricket in the park or down the beach. Be outside enjoying Christmas in the sun.
That sounds great, so not a white Christmas for you.
It's definitely not a white Christmas where I'm from.
But in places where there is a white Christmas, some people like to partake in winter activities.
Well, it is a winter festival.
Yep, and some of these activities can range from skiing,
ice skating,
sledging, just anything you can do on the snow. And, as it happens, you can go skiing here in Ulaanbaatar. So this week, I sent Julian out to give it a go. How did you get on?
Well, I was a little bit rusty at first, but I think after a few runs I got the hang of it. But you'll have to see for yourselves.
Let's check it out.
At the Sky Ski Resort just outside of Ulaanbaatar. This is one of the premier skiing resorts around. It's got four ski runs, it's got two ski lifts, and a couple of beginner's runs for those of you who are not too confident in your skiing abilities like me. But I think I'm all ready to go. I've got the skis, got my nice jacket. Let's go have a go. Top of the hill, just got off the ski lift, and I'm gonna see how I go. going down the hill, see how many times I fall over. Here goes. That's one side conquered. Now to take it up a notch. There I go.
Wow, so that looked like a lot of fun.
Well, it was after I stopped falling over all the time.
Yeah, you did fall over a few times. But what other winter sports can we do here in Ulaanbaatar?
Well, now that we've done skiing, we could try ice skating.
Hey, that's a good idea.
Yeah, ice skating is just like rollerblading, except you have a blade instead of wheels, and it's done on ice.
Makes sense.
Yeah, it was invented around the 13th or 14th century in Holland, and ice skating is used for lots of things. It's used for ice hockey, figure skating, and even ice skating racing in the Olympics.
Sounds good.
Yeah, are you any good at ice skating?
Well, as it happens, I tried it out this week, and not really. But you can judge for yourselves if you want to have a look and see how I go on.
I definitely want to take a look.
Wonderland, winter wonderland, wonderland. Sleigh bells ring, are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, oh, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is a bluebird here to stay. Is a new bird, he's singing a song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. Well, in the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no, man. But you can do the job when you're in town. Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire to face unafraid all the plans that we've made, walking in a winter wonderland.
In the meadow we can build a snowman and pretend that he's a circus clown. We'll have lots of fun with Mr. Snowman
until the other kiddies knock him down. Oh, when it snows, ain't it thrilling? Though your nose gets chillin', we'll frolic.